Well, my main hydraulic line coming out of my lift is leaking. I think it's leaking from right here because the fitting is nice and tight. So that's a disappointment. All right, guys, welcome back to another short episode of Arrow's Garage. I'm going to be working on my minivan today. It developed a really bad oil leak, like almost a straight stream. When I crawl under there and look, it looks like it's dripping from the drain plug on the oil pan, but it only drips when it's running, so it's obviously not the drain plug. I'm hoping it's like an oil pressure sensor or something up on the back of the block that has cracked and oil is coming out. I've had that happen on some Chevy vehicles before, and actually the GMT 800 LS engines, or LS style engines, are kind of notorious for their oil pressure sensors to leak. So thanks for joining us. Take a second to subscribe. We're almost to 500. Actually, by the time I upload this video, we'll probably be over 500. So thank you so much for your subscriptions, if that's the case. Anyways, at the time of making this video, we're at like 464 subscribers. So thank you so much. Please continue to subscribe. Please continue to help me grow the channel. I don't know what's wrong with this thing yet, so we're gonna go ahead and investigate together and find out what is leaking on it. All right, so as you can tell, this hole underneath is just completely soaked and bathed in oil. And I'm not sure where we're coming from. There's oil all over the oil filter housing. Maybe it's something as stupid as the filter's just loose. Although, it does look like there is a oil pressure switch on the back. You can see it. I'll put a little arrow on the screen or something. It might be leaking from there. So, I'm going to do some investigating real quick and try to figure out what's wrong because I can't hold my flashlight and my phone and work at the same time. I'm not that talented. All right, so after spraying it down with some brake cleaner and wiping it off, I unplugged the plug coming out of the end of that oil pressure switch, and it's just doused in oil. So I'm fairly confident that the oil pressure switch is the culprit. So I'm gonna grab one of my kids, throw them up inside the van on the lift, have them start the car, and let it run for a second so I can physically get eyes on where the oil is coming from. Okay, this was my camera person. So if the video is shaky or staring at her feet or she's got her fingers in front of it like this, it's her fault. It is. Say sorry.
Sorry.
Say please subscribe.
Please subscribe.
All right, so I'm gonna crawl under the car here, grab a flashlight. Saloma, can you hear me? Okay, to start it, you're gonna turn that key all the way forward. Once it starts up, just take your hands off the key. Yeah, go ahead and start it. Oh, I'm not seeing anything super obvious, really quick leaking. All right, I'm gonna do some investigating, and when I find it, I'll point the camera back at it. All right, so as you can see, it is leaking quite a bit. It doesn't appear to be the switch itself, but it looks like it is leaking. Oh man, I'm gonna have to put arrows on the screen when I edit this in post because you can't really see. Anyways, there's that housing that the oil filter plugs into and that the oil pressure switch plugs into. It looks like it's leaking from the seal between that housing. So I'm gonna pull that off. Turn it off, sweetie. Just turn the key back. Thank you. Are you comfortable up there? Okay, because it's gonna be about an hour before I can lower the car. So lay back, listen to some music, watch a TV show or something. Oh, there's no internet connection inside the shop because of all the metal, so. Don't be giving me the stink eye like that.
Hey, why don't you take this opportunity to say please like and subscribe?
Have no love for my kids.
No.
I'm kidding. They're pretty amazing, aren't they?
Please like and subscribe.
There you go. All right, that opened up a little more of a room here. So I'm gonna grab the camera here. And so that is the bracket that is leaking. So that needs to come off. And hopefully it's not gonna be a royal pain to get off. It looks like a bunch of maybe 12 millimeter bolts. Okay, so I found the culprit. I went ahead and got the tire off, got the, the oil filter housing, pressure switch housing. There's some valves in there. I'm not really sure everything this does yet, but I did find the culprit. So we're gonna look at it right now. So here is the seal or gasket that goes inside all these grooves, and it is brittle. It was cracked, and when I was trying to pry it to see the crack better, it just broke into pieces. So you can see this is just, it should not do that. This should be, I'm assuming, more of a rubbery consistency, not very brittle plastic. So it had a crack right in here, which correlates to over here somewhere. So I'm fairly confident that is the issue and not the $80 VTEC oil pressure switch that I thought was the problem. So that's a good thing, unless this gasket slash seal is $100, then so anyway, so I'm gonna run to the parts store, get this, put it back on, and I'm not sure how much of that I'm gonna video. I'm obviously not gonna video the boring drive to the parts store because it's 30 minutes away, unless you guys just wanna listen to elevator for 30 minutes while I drive. So I will be back when I have the new part. Hopefully it's not like my other videos where like, hey, it's been 3 months, now we're gonna put it back together, because this is my wife's van and she can't wait 3 months to get it back. So this is happening today. All right, just got back from AutoZone, got the part that I need. I had to take the van down off the lift because some of my kids' jackets were in it and stuff. So I'm gonna get the van back up on the lift, go ahead and throw this on there. Hopefully it's the right one. Well, this is definitely the right part because it fits in there, and it's definitely rubbery like I figured it should be. Okay, as you can see, I've got it all back on. That's the plug I thought was going to be leaking. There's another plug up there that you have to unplug to pull it down. Got the oil filter back on. I'm going to lower it down off the lift a little bit so I can climb up on a chair and start it. Kids are over at grandma's house, so I can't hoist a little kid up in there to do it. So I think we've got it fixed. Nope, I just saw some leakage again. Okay, no bueno. There you can see some leakage. Looks like it's coming from up above there somewhere. Well, that's disappointing. The kit did come with a couple extra O-rings, so I guess I'm going to take it back apart and replace the rest of the O-rings, which I should have done when it was on the bench. You'd think I'd learned this stuff by now. All right, well, here's the other piece that I think failed. It was leaking from here. I broke that when I took it off. Obviously those gaskets are brittle and they're completely flattened out. They have no squishiness. I think that's the scientific term. Squishiness. It's cold out. I'm thinking maybe it's just, you start the car up in the morning, oil pressure is a lot higher than normal because of how cold it is. Maybe that's what caused the seals to finally fail, both of them at the same time. All right, got it all on there. I'm gonna spray it down with some brake cleaner and try it again. All right, I'm not seeing any
leakage or moisture seeping out of there this time. I think we're good to go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. That fixed the problem and is no longer leaking. The car has been idling for about 5 minutes now, and there is absolutely no moisture building up around where that those gaskets were, or seals. What is the difference between a seal and a gasket? I don't know. I'll Google it. Anyways, thanks for watching. We are almost to 500 subscribers, so please continue to hit that subscribe button and the little bell thing, and I'm hopefully going to do something for 500 subscribers, a little video to say thank you. I don't know. I've got a pop tester for injection, diesel injectors. I've got a torch, so I might make some sort of pyrotechnic stuff. But anyway, stay tuned. That should be the next video if enough of you hit like and subscribe on this video. So again, thank you so much for watching the channel. Yeah, go out there and fix your car. Don't take it to a shop. Those guys charge too much money. Yeah, that was inspirational. I'll have to work on a catchphrase or something. My kids already make fun of me for starting all my videos with "What's up, guys?" So they said I need to get a T-shirt that says "What's up, guys?" So if you're interested in buying a T-shirt that says "What's up, guys?" No, anyways, that won't make the cut. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.